Hello, my name is Baconism, I'm the permanent damage guy, and this is how I beat Minecraft without mining. I created the world and then immediately decided to lose the challenge for whatever reason. My decision in the end was that I'd just continue using the seed because I hadn't seen it yet, so there was no point in me really restarting. I should rephrase that, quote unquote restarting. There isn't much you can do in Minecraft without mining. I mean, it's literally in the name. The only thing that I could really do at this point was run around and wait for nighttime looking for any structure. So that's exactly what I did. After I slid into the void, I came across a village. Whilst I didn't find a crafting table or any kind of wood for that matter, much to my surprise, I got the most useful item in this challenge. And yes, I'm dead serious, a bucket was the most useful item. Anyway, I saw the village's emeralds, participated in money laundering, then walked in a straight line. I did this for around 3,000 blocks. Well, it's not really fair to say a straight line now I think about it. I decided I should at least try to get some blocks and some sort of wood. To put it simply, I just used creepers in the nighttime to obtain these resources. The viewer retention seems to plummet as well when I talk about the rules of the challenge, so from now on they will either be in the comments or the description. I will not be going through them on the video. Regardless, I nearly died doing this, so I guess that was fun. I ran through the days and the nights, slowly running out of bread, when I finally saw the first spark of hope. The task of building a netherfall is tedious as all living hell when you can't break blocks, and it's even worse when you need to light it and can't obtain flint and steel. My initial plan was to get bones to grow one of the few saplings in my inventory. I am ashamed to admit that I almost died, a few times actually, but it was alright because this spawner didn't want to work for whatever reason and contained the bones I needed. It wasn't long after this when I realized I had a singular block of wood and some lava in my inventory. I lit the portal feeling like an idiot that I didn't realize this sooner. Then my stupidity was its own undoing once again because I realized the move that I just made without a shadow of a doubt in my mind was the worst thing I possibly could have freaking done. Anyway, time to go to hell. Literally, I spawned in a basalt delta. Son of a bitch. We're gonna just skip over about 30 minutes of footage because everything before this clip is utterly boring. And this is kind of the only interesting part. Wait, actually, I kinda wanna get that. I mean, there's always the chance, right? Oh shit. It didn't register with me that there was a bean child there. Like, at all. Also, we're at that point now. I'm not gonna say it. I'm just gonna hint at it. Press it. Press the big red button.
You know you want to.
The Nether sucks to navigate with a limited amount of blocks, and if you're wondering how to get blocks in the Nether, let me show you.
Sounds right.
After having a run-in with this magma cube, actually, you know what, you don't care. Here's the Nether Fortress. Do you know how to get up there? Because I f***ing don't. Actually, I do. You wouldn't be watching this video otherwise. Either that, or it'd be called something like, I failed to beat Minecraft without mining, here's how. Oh. Wait. After looking at this for about 10 minutes, I used my very scarce amount of blocks to climb to the fortress and screamed so loudly that my microphone just stopped picking up audio for I think the next hour. Now that is when I realized it finally came back on anyway. During this time, I tried to lure Blaze onto this path and ultimately gave up. I came back and realized I have the facilities to make a crafting table and therefore a weapon. I can't explain to you how happy I was not to punch Blaze 15 or more times for the chance of a blaze rod. Before my triumph though, I did have to suffer a little bit. In hindsight, the way I got to the Nether Fortress was actually pretty reckless and stupid. I could have softlocked myself in a chasm and might have needed to either restart or make a video about how I failed, which a short is good enough for that, right? I'm not funny. Here is my stupid ass dueling an enderman I didn't know I looked at. Anyway, back in the overworld, because apart from wasting an enderpearl, I just mainly climbed precarious staircases, I ran 500 blocks, then found a red portal. I did what any rational human being would do after this. I turned my ass back around, retreated to my portal so I could craft a pair of shears. I can't mine, but I can at least build and trade with wool, so there's that. Anyway, so let's not talk about that. After wasting 2 hours at this clericless village, I took my frustration out on this random cartographer's house and somehow ran 1,000 blocks before realizing my blaze rods were in a chest at that village. Before this realization, I decided that I'm not going to trade for pearls. Instead, I'm going to kill Enderman in the overworld because I hate myself, I guess. I'm not really sure why I chose to do this. Do you know what? How about we skip to the good part? We have all been thinking about it. How the hell do I get into the stronghold? I can't begin to explain how lucky I was that these strongholds spawned like this in the ocean. And looking at it, it doesn't quite make sense right this second. Creepers can't break blocks underwater, so how do you get inside? Here's a quick spectator view of the stronghold, I guess. I won't explain. I just want you to watch and wait, because this plan I came up with I think is genuinely incredible, and I don't think a lot of people would have thought of this. To begin, I had to swim 1,000 blocks to get some redstone. I ran through a desert, tripped down a cave, and used the old pig sprite as a portrait. I then made the 1,000 block trek back to craft my savior, and apparently you need cobblestone for it, instead of cobble deep slate, so time to run 2,000 blocks. Yay. I made 2 spruce trapdoors, a lever, and a single piston. I took everything and swam down into the cave. I made sure to open the first gate before placing the second one. I then waterlocked the gates, and I was in.
We're fucking in!
Now, what I said is pretty brief, and I think I get to relax after waiting 3 hours for one creeper because this moron despawned. And I wish I was joking. Everything has fallen into place though. I looted the stronghold and placed the eyes into the portal. I then set out for the last time to kill the remaining Enderman, then returned to finish what I started. It's anticlimactic, but that's that. I'm just screwing with you. I didn't play Minecraft incorrectly for 8 hours just to fail and give up. I killed the dragon and broke his kid's jaw. And so, I save us for the last time. Hello, my name is Deaconism. I'm the permanent damage guy. And this is how I beat Minecraft without mining. 8 hours, we fucking done it, let's go. Oh my god. If you made it to the end, thanks for watching, and I'll just see you next time. Bye.